My name is Matt Elliott, and I'm here at the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon on Highway 99. Today I want to show you a rig that just came in. It's a brand new Montana fifth wheel. This is the 295 RL. It's a great coach. You're going to love it. A couple of things I want to point out about Montana. Montana has been for many years a benchmark in the industry for building residential quality fifth wheels that are good year round, fifth wheels that can handle freezing weather. That's what this coach is. They've been doing it for a long time and they are well known for their quality. Now I'm going to show you quite a bit on this coach as we go through this video. For starters, I want to point out that this has a full fiberglass enclosure on the front. This goes all around the corners, edges, and seams. It's good looking and aerodynamic, but it really serves a great purpose of really making it difficult for your front end to leak on this coach. This is kind of like putting the hull of a boat on the end of your trailer, and that really is important because this is the part that beats into the wind when you're driving. So that's a big deal. Another thing that's interesting is that we have the Road Armor hitch on this. When you pull a fifth wheel, you can get some action from the fifth wheel that is unpleasant when you're driving, but this has a big rubber bushing built right into it, and it's got a head design that allows it to absorb shock, so you don't have that kind of an experience. Another little detail, this is a patented feature for Keystone. We've actually got a mirror built into the front of this coach, so when you're backing up, you can see your hitch, and you can connect easily because it's reflected in this mirror. It's a very simple thing, but not everybody does that. So that's a really good deal. Let's take a look over here. One of the first things you notice for this coach is it's got a massive storage area. If you look under here, you can see it's very tall, so you can, you know, carry coolers and larger items in here. It's easy to get things in and out. And you can also see in here that this is all aluminum superstructure, and there's another thing you probably can't see very well, but the heating system for this coach blows heat directly into this enclosure. So this is going to stay warm with all your cargo, and that's dynamite. We've got the new steps, the solid steps. These things are great because when you walk on them, first of all, they're very stable, very easy to do, especially if you have sore knees or ankles or anything like that, because they're not wobbly. They also don't transfer bounce as you go into the coach. So this is much more stable when you walk in and out. It's a great kind of step. Now, this has this little green tag here, Solar Flex Protect 220. This coach has already got 220 watts of solar panel built into it. That's going to reinforce your batteries all the time. If you're storing your trailer and you don't have a power supply for it, it's going to keep your batteries up so you don't have that kind of a problem where you go out and find dead batteries. That's a really good idea. It'll also reinforce your batteries as you're using the trailer too, so you'll get some continuous charging from sunlight. We have awning here over our in our patio area. So this actually has two awnings. There's a big one in the front and then one over here, because whenever we do a patio side slide, it kind of comes out and uses up your patio space. So we've just added this extra power awning so we can increase that space. Works really nice. You come around the back, there's some interesting points on the back of this coach to look at. First of all, you can see it has a ladder. So that's important because we need to go up and check our seals periodically, do a little maintenance, clean it. Sometimes we need to get debris off the top of our coach if anything's fallen down from trees overhead. This ladder gives me access to do all the kinds of things I need, and it proves that this is a fully walkable roof. This roof is strong enough to walk on. I'm not saying you shouldn't be careful when you go up there. There's no handrails, but you can go up there and not worry about your weight on the roof of this trailer. Another thing that's great is we have a receiver mount right here, a 2-inch receiver, and we also have a 4-pin electrical wire here. The purpose of that is if I want to put something on the back, like a bike rack or a cargo carrier, you know, a platform cargo carrier, then we can add that storage to the back of this coach. And then the purpose of the wiring is if what I'm putting on the back covers up my taillights, then I can have other taillights plugged into this. And that'll give me good visibility and everybody can tell when I'm turning. This is pre-wired for a backup camera. There's a little bib up there. And so if you feel the need to have a backup camera, it's very easy to add that to this trailer. And we come around this side here, you could see a couple of things that are interesting. First of all, these big slide outs are rack and pinion slides. Rack and pinion is a very reliable, durable way to do a slide. Usually you don't see them on above the floor slide outs. These big slides give you under the floor, and that's where that equipment goes. And of course, that gives you a much taller slide out on the interior, so there's a lot more room. Another thing I really like on this coach is that we have a shore power connector here that's removable. That's important because if I have the kind that pulls out, I'm making a hole in my trailer. A mouse can go up that cord and get in my trailer. No mouse hole with this one. And of course, it's also nice because I can, when I'm not using the trailer, I can disconnect that cord and store it someplace secure. Okay. Now, one of the things I mentioned at the very beginning was that this is a Four Seasons trailer. And we lift this up right here, and you can see here's our water station. All of our plumbing fixtures are internal. So with this one, if my furnace is on, I don't have to worry about things getting frozen. Even the gate valves for my wastewater system are internal. So the pipes that are external, the part that's on the outside of the underbelly, that is gonna stay empty so it won't freeze. That's really what makes a trailer Four Seasons. And so that's what they do in here. That's dynamite. And of course you can see tremendous access for your storage area right here. Now this coach also has an automatic leveling system, and the controls for that are in that little box there. So all I have to do when I'm ready to unhook is I can use that to get it off my truck, and then I can level and stabilize the coach automatically. It's great. Let's take a look inside. Follow me. Okay, so now let's take a look at this 2024 295RL Montana from the inside. First thing you're going to notice when you walk into this coach is it's very, very spacious. We've got two big opposing slides that go out, and when everything's slid out, you really have a ton of room in here. And that's enhanced by all these big windows. You've got tremendous window space, lots of light coming in, and lots of ventilation, so you can have a lot of fresh air in here. There's also a high capacity exhaust fan up in the ceiling with a remote control so that I can use that to change the air in here too. So if I crack a window and turn that on, I can really freshen up my trailer. This also has a rain sensor on it. So if I have my vent lid opened up and it starts to rain, it'll automatically close. That's a pretty nice feature. Now, looking back here in the living space, first of all, we've got this big trifold sofa, and what a trifold does is it makes a really comfortable guest bed. It's a queen size bed, queen RV style. It's not exactly the same size as a queen in your house, but it'll certainly do the trick for two adults, and that's a nice versatility. Also, then we have power recliners. These are Thomas Paine recliners, and they're sitting right across from your great big television. And you've got a nice electric fireplace. These things are great because now I can heat my coach without burning propane, and it's a lot quieter than a forced air furnace. This is really a nice thing to have on board. And we have a home theater system from JBL, which is excellent. There's also a lot of storage up here, and there's storage behind this TV. Now, as we go forward, we look in the galley. This is an island kitchen. Everybody likes these because you get extra counter space. Has a great big recessed stainless steel sink, single handle faucet, which is dynamite. And then lots of counter space here. And you'll see that we have a large oven and a big three burner cooking surface. And there's even storage down below the oven here for pots and pans. In this area, we've got a big storage area with room for a garbage can. A lot of RVs don't give you enough room for a garbage can, so that's nice. And there's covers for this sink as well. More drawers. And then when we come back here, a huge pantry. So I've got tremendous resources for food storage with all this cabinetry. And then we have a really nice hutch up here for more storage. Stuff can go here, stuff can go down here, and I have even more counter space. Great place to put your toaster or your blender or something like that. Now this is really special. I want to show you this refrigerator because this is a 12 volt all electric fridge. Most RVs have a gas electric fridge, and the gas equipment takes up a lot of room in the back of that refrigerator. And so I get less actual space in the fridge. But with this one, there's none of that propane equipment, so it's a lot deeper. So this is all freezer and that is all refrigerator. And this works just off 12 volt, which means I have batteries, I have solar, I have shore power when I'm plugged in, and I'm making 12 volt when I'm towing, which means I can leave this on even when I'm driving. So if you're taking a longer trip, typically you're supposed to turn off your propane for your fridge and people worry about their food warming up. With this one, I can just leave it on all the time. Fantastic idea. And we have a freestanding table and chair design. This table's actually not freestanding, it's mounted to the wall, but the chairs are freestanding, so it makes the trailer feel a lot more open and kind of homey. And I can take these chairs out and move them around or put them under my awning or do whatever I want. There's also a leaf here, so this table can extend out quite a bit, so you have a little bit more room for you and your guests. Okay, so that's a quick look at the main living area and the galley. Let's go up and look at the bathroom. As we go, I want to point to this. That is a vacuum cleaner. This has got a built-in vacuum. That's pretty neat. I want to mention, this little tag here says that we can get lithium-ion batteries for this coach. This coach has a special feature where it will auto-detect the type of battery you're using. It used to be if you were going to upgrade your batteries, you needed to get different electronic equipment to sense those batteries and work properly, but this is all set up for it. So if you decide you need the big batteries, the big lithium-ion package, this one's all ready to go. Okay, let's take a look up here. So this has a really excellent bathroom and bedroom design. We're going to come in through this side door, and you can see that it's very open. In fact, I don't know, let's have you go over here. So this bathroom is great because, first of all, it's got a really big shower, and the shower has a seat in it. Now, I'm not a little guy and I've got plenty of room, and you can see how much taller you can be in this than I am. I'm just under 6 feet tall, so you're not going to bump your head in this thing. Got a porcelain toilet. That toilet points not into a wall, so plenty of room for your legs. Beautiful, again, a recessed stainless sink. Nice medicine cabinet, lots more storage. Then we come over here, and this is a huge storage cabinet here. We've got a lot of room. Now, what's really cool on this is that this cabinet can also support a washer-dryer unit. So if you're in need of a washer-dryer in your coach, it'll go right in there. That's perfect. Now, as we look up in the main bedroom area, there's a lot to talk about up here. First thing you notice, king-size bed. So we got a king-size bed, nice big nightstand here, and they added nightstands to both sides above the bed, so, and there's power supplies. So if you have something you want to set up here and plug in, you can do it. That works really great. If we come around here, got a nice chest of drawers, so you can have a place for all your socks and everything. And we have this wonderful front area. This has a window. That front window changes everything about your bedroom. It makes it feel so much bigger, so much roomier. There's a blind that pulls down so you can darken the room. But then I have these huge drawers, lots more storage. Right there, lots of places to set stuff. So, you know, and I think of all the different things I take with me camping. It's nice to have a place to put things so you're not tripping over it all the time. I could stay really organized when I have these kind of spaces here. Then, of course, we have storage on the sides. So we got a big, beautiful rig. We've got lots of cool technologies and innovations in this coach, and there's a lot more to talk about. So that's a quick look at the brand new 2024 Montana High Country 295RL. It's a great fifth wheel. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'd love to talk to you about it, so feel free to give me a call. My name's Matt Elliott, and you can reach me at 541-954-8495. You have a great day.